Yay! Happy 420! What are you doing? How are you celebrating? Or is it just a day like any other? You are just as high on 419 as you'll be on 420.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, have you ever done it on weed? Woo! I'm getting pictures. Are you getting texts?
Oh, hell yeah, dude. People are checking in. My wake and bake this morning is called Dositos.
Dositos.
We'll eat infused peach cobbler later. Ooh.
We've never lived in a time of culinary craftsmanship in regards to marijuana THC. Like right now. Because growing up, you, I, Josh, you were close to God, which is why you had a pretty prominent career at the age of 12. It was the brownie. That's all it was. Unless you were eating a pot brownie, maybe a pot cookie. That's all it was.
Yeah.
You got nothing else. But now you got the cobbler. You've got the butters. You've got chicken. You know, like, I saw a THC chicken fried steak.
Hell yeah.
I mean, that's good.
Yeah, Do-si-do. Look at this. It is an indica dominant strain. Indica is Spiegel for is if you think of indica and then you think of indicouch, that'll make you feel nice and relaxed and calming.
I'm already relaxed.
Are you though?
I'm already relaxed.
It sounds like
are you though?
You could be more
are
relaxed. You could be.
Josh,
would you partake if it was something you could literally walk into a Safeway and just take off the shelf? No prescription, no dispensary. You can get your Diet Peach Snapple in aisle 4, and you can get your THC gummies in aisle 5.
It's possible. I might try it, but it would have to be very tame. It would
Can I ask you this? What are your main concerns? What do you think would happen?
Crack usage.
I might die. I might get
nobody. I don't think anybody has ever died of a weed overdose.
I don't want to have any negative effects. I don't have the slightest interest in doing it. I never have. That's why I've never done it. I've never done any type of drugs.
Do you think it might have
and
some,
I don't hate America.
There you
might
are.
Have, do you think it might have some benefits?
It's possible, I suppose. I mean, I'm sure it does.
What if it completely changed your life? What if you just became...
Even more insane?
No, like, you know, all of the social anxiety goes away. You're able to get out of the house. You become gregarious.
Yeah, you're just out there slinging all over town.
Just imagine that.
Would that be good for the show?
Yes, it would. Yes, it would. It would be... Well, it would be... The current shape of you is fantastic, but imagine we come back from, like, holiday break. We've got, like, 2 weeks off. We're not allowed to take 2 weeks off in a row? Since when? And you suddenly are just, you're this completely new guy. You've heard me make the joke before that there was the jock in high school in ninth grade whose cousin gets them stoned over summer break, and they come back completely different. I remember, not John Cunningham, Trucker John. There was a John Cunningham at my school, Maurice J. McDonough.
Comes back. He's got a hemp necklace on, tie-dye t-shirt.
I was like, wait a minute. You were giving us swirlies and had like the tightest Ted Nugent t-shirt on.
What's up, bro?
No. What's up, bro? Me? You bounced my head off a locker once.
Nah, man. It's cool. I'm different now.
It's not cool. I still have PTSD.
I'm sorry about that, man. Bro, let's talk it out, man. I didn't mean to do that.
Okay. But just please, no more swirlies, okay? I'm still picking BVD out of the crack of my ass from that atomic wedgie. Yeah, 410-338-1098. What are you doing to celebrate the 420? Trucker John, speaking of, holy hell, he has got the blue cheese weed. Look at that sticky icky. That John, how long is that going to last you? He's holding up a pouch. I can't tell if that's the size of like a giant Capri Sun. It's a pouch. One side's aluminum. The other side's clear. Translucent, and it's just filled with these shimmering nuggets. How long does that last to Trucker John? Trucker John, I'm curious.
Well, that's not his. That's just
that's a person that sent him that photo, because he'd never do that. How long does it last your friend? I'm winking towards camera four. Let's go to the phones, 410-338-1098. Let's talk to James in the Cape. What's up? Happy 420.
Happy 420.
Happy 420.
Yeah. I'm actually at the jittery stage of the edible right now.
The jittery. Oh, nice. Okay. I mean, you've seen the meme online where everyone's like, this edible ain't. And then the next thing you know, they're French kissing a four-slice toaster.
What'd you ingest?
Your stomach feels like you're going through your butt. I actually make homemade coconut oil, and I put that in my coffee.
Really?
And, the
you
coffee.
Start your morning with coffee-laced coconut oil.
Yeah, my friend and I call it poison coffee.
Okay.
And we had a story. We were working in a restaurant, and we probably ingested like 200 milligrams before a Friday night rush.
Oh, my
and,
God.
No way.
You say 200?
No, we were mumbling the food to each other, and the chef's like, what the hell's wrong with you guys? And for about a week, they thought we were on heroin. And we weren't. We were just on an edible.
If you do so much weed, that's how I say it, you do weed. If you do so much weed that they think you're on heroin, that's a level of stoned I've never known. And obviously, before I found Josh and God, same day, same person, I would get high and... Yeah, I'd become a mushmouth moron, more so than you're used to. But never to the point where people are like, all right, check for track marks.
I was trying to mumble paper towels because I was sweating so profusely. I couldn't really see because there was like sweat getting in my eyes. Okay. And I'm just over a skillet cooking scallops.
Oh.
And I was just like trying to say paper towel. And he kept putting them on a wet cutting board with scallop juices.
Oh.
I'm like, no, man, it's for my face. And I just remember yelling, it's for my face.
Oh, and you're just this sloppy sweat hog dripping into the scallops. Oh, some guy's got to eat your weed sweat scallop.
Oh.
That's gross. Let's talk to Nick. Nick, what's going on, man? Sounds like you're a bit of a botanist. Nicky. Says on screen here, Nick can grow a strain for us. Come on, Nick. Be there, Nick. You son of a bee. I want you to grow one for us. He gone. Nick, I'm going to put you on hold. I want to come back to you. Oh, no. He got too high. Nick says, online anyways, another Nick, Indica sends me into a panic. If I don't fall asleep immediately, I'm convinced I can't breathe. I can't sleep. Sativa is calming. Not sleepy, but calm. Okay. Trucker John got back to us about that big old bag of weed, that huge bag of weed.
Smoke weed every day.
He says, that bag I sent you will last 2 weeks, depending on how busy I am. Excuse me, how busy my friend is. That is an ounce. That is an ounce. Josh, have you ever seen in person a physical bag of marijuana in front of you nearby?
I think so. I've seen a lot of people I knew when I was in school did the devil's drug, but I never partook.
Never inhaled.
The dormitory reeked.
Oh, I
reeked.
Bet.
In fact, when I say some people partook. I mean everybody except me. I probably got a secondary high.
Oh, it's a lock. You got a contact high, man. I tell the tale of my mom taking me to see Motley Crue and us having just about the worst seats you can have and the people in front of us just smoking weed all night long in row Y when we were in row Z. And a 13-year-old Justin and his 39-year-old mom got rip S, which was pretty great because my mom kept running back to the concession stand to grab me fresh nachos. Let's talk to Nick. Nick is here now. Nick, good morning.
Good morning. Sorry, guys. I hit the mute button by accident.
Nice.
A little stoned this morning.
What a stoned-ass move to pull. So.
Hey, I ate 240-milligram gummies this morning to start my day off with. I think I'm functioning pretty freaking well.
240-gram gummies? 80 grams?
Yeah, sure. Yeah 80 milligrams. Milligrams. Not grams. Milligrams. Yeah.
80 milligrams this morning. And what's the rest of your day look like?
Oh, it's looking good. I mean, it's just starting now.
What do you got to do today?
Jesus, listen to you.
I ain't got nothing to do today. I took a day off. This is my day.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Hell yeah, dude.
420. I'm going to grow weed today. That's about it.
Yeah.
Well, you guys really want a strain? You guys want to call it sweet potato dreams?
Hey, if you want to make something on our behalf, it is a completely unofficial product of yours. We cannot have any official affiliation.
Of course.
But if you want to go ahead and maybe send a photo in, we wouldn't be mad.
It's going to take a few months because you got to cross it and cross it back and forth. But any strains you guys want, particularly thinking about?
I have nothing to do with it.
Something to help with social anxiety.
You said, you said you superhead dreams. I'm thinking like something like, I don't know, with some blue dreams and maybe gelato, blue dreams and birthday cake.
Can you maybe do anything like blue chew dreams? Is there any weed that can help me with ED? That'd be nice. Not to say I'm going to stop taking my blue chew edibles, but I wouldn't mind being able to smoke myself back into an erection.
You know, I mean, a heavy indica actually works for me. I mean, I don't have any ED, but it definitely boosts my sex drive.
Okay. This guy's the best. All right, I'm putting him on hold. Misha, he is officially the show botanist. Let's talk to...
love that guy.
That guy is so much fun to hang out with. That laugh is infectious. Like gonorrhea. Let's talk to Denise. D-Nice. Glenn Burney, good morning.
D-Nice is here. Good morning.
Hi, Angel.
I had gotten my card, my medical card, and went to the dispensary, and, you know, they said, do you have a tolerance? And I said, no, I haven't smoked in years, but, I mean, not that I ever had, but got the stuff, went home and tried one hit, and I lay in my bed for 4 hours thinking my teeth were falling out.
Whoa.
I was certain my hair was growing. I could feel and see everything, but I couldn't move to grab my phone to call for emergent help. If I'd gotten it on the street, I was sure I was dead, but I knew I was at a dispensary. So I wanted to ask, it's Justin who has the issue with, he doesn't want to do it. Is he a control freak?
No, Josh and I have pretty bad anxiety, and back when the weed was weaker, and I would still ask a friend that I knew for 17 years to their face, are you a cop? Pretty much whenever we did it. My anxiety was just too bad for it.
Okay. Well, I did find out later when I went back, they gave me something with like 35% THC, and they said as a newbie, I should have had about 2 or 3%.
Oh, yeah, you dove. You were supposed to have a White Claw, and you had yourself a Johnny Walker Blue right off the bat. Damn. Okay. Well, Josh, has this swayed you at all to maybe lean more towards it?
No.
Cocaine it is.